everyone. My name is Michelle, and I'm a PhD candidate in the Department of Chemistry at the University of Alberta. Today, I will be talking about a technique we use in our research called solid-state nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, or NMR for short, and how we can use NMR to understand the structure of energy materials. Everything around us is made up of matter, from the food that we eat, to the air that we breathe, or the screen that you're using to watch this video. And all this matter is made up of atoms. When these atoms interact and bind, they create molecules and molecular structures. But why do we want to learn about molecular structures? Think of it like playing with Legos. While each individual Lego block is important, we have to understand how the blocks fit together to create new designs. Likewise, we also need to understand how atoms work together to create different molecular structures, which can allow us to create better materials for many purposes, such as harnessing energy. So how can we learn more about molecular structures? What techniques can we use to study such small interactions? That's where solid-state NMR comes into play. Solid-state NMR is a powerful technique since we are able to study molecular structures at the atomic level. When we put the molecules in a strong magnetic field, the nuclei of some atoms, or the very center of some atoms, will begin to act like tiny magnets. When we apply a radio pulse, the nuclei will resonate at a specific frequency. Think of it like tuning a guitar. When you pluck a guitar string, it will resonate at a specific frequency according to the note that you want to play. These resonant frequencies are then measured and converted into peaks on a graph, which we call an NMR spectrum. Depending on how high the peak is, the signal intensity, what the peak looks like, the line shape, or where the peak shows up on the graph, the chemical shift, we are able to determine what is happening around these specific atoms. Using this information, we can unravel the complex structure of our materials and learn how to develop newer and better materials. Solar energy is a renewable resource that uses the energy from the sun to produce electricity. Since it's renewable, it means it never runs out. It also doesn't produce greenhouse gas emissions, meaning it's an important tool against climate change. One example of an exciting solar energy material is perovskites. This unique compound has the ability to harvest light, which is then converted into energy when used in solar cells. In our research, we use solid-state NMR to understand how these materials are structured and what gives them their unique ability to convert light into electricity. By analyzing our NMR spectra, we can create fingerprints that relate to each specific structure and their unique properties. Using these fingerprints, we get a foundation on what structure provides the best solar energy properties. With NMR, we are now able to understand how these materials are structured and what gives them their unique properties in order to develop new and improved energy alternatives. Thank you so much for joining me today as we learned a bit about what solid-state NMR is and how we can use it to study energy materials. Also, a special thank you to all our sponsors.
Thank you so much for watching Future Energy Systems video. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of our exciting content. Check out the links below to our website and learning page where you can find activities, learning extension, and more. You can also sign up on the website for notifications for future videos and interactive opportunities. There's so much to learn as we explore our energy future.